Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, let's just give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endureth forever. And we certainly do thank and praise God for another opportunity to lift up the name of Jesus, to go before him with thanksgiving, and to go before him in praise. I want to welcome you to another broadcast of Christian Ministries of the Apostolic Faith Church. Amen. Where I'm the lead pastor, Suffolk and Bishop-elect Frankie L. Quinn. And we thank God for our lovely wife, Tracy Quinn, and for our leadership that are here. And we do thank God for our praise team and our members of Christian Ministries, of the Apostolic Faith Church. So right now, we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. Amen. We want to pray for our members. And the Harpers put forth a request. We're going to pray for the sister that the Lord will bless in the name of Jesus. And we want to pray, amen, for men and women and children everywhere, that the Lord will continue to save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. Some people say, well, I'm going to try the Lord after they've tried everything else. But I'm here to tell you that he should be the first option, amen, not the last option. So I'm glad that we can come boldly to the throne and call on the name of Jesus. Let every heart pray, O gracious Father, in the name of Jesus. We certainly do thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to minister in song and minister in word and to those that need help in the name of Jesus and to lifter, hallelujah, be the lifter of those that want to rejoice and magnify the name of the Lord. We pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you bless our service, let your hand be upon us and strengthen us with your grace and your mercy. Bless the praise team in a mighty way in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. So right now, we'll turn you over to our praise team. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everybody. How many of you glad to be in the house of the Lord today? Today, we just want to let you know that even though we're going through a crisis, and even though things are not going the way we want them to go, our God is still reigning. He's still reigning on the throne. He's still working with us. He is still surprising for his people. So just get with us at home and let us know that you are happy with us to celebrate that our God is still reigning. Oh, sing my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Lord, you reign above every name. Yes, sing my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Lord, you reign.
Our God reigns.
Lord, you reign.
atmosphere with worship today. Hallelujah, wherever you are. Hallelujah, at your home. Hallelujah, just open your hands, open your hearts. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and worship Him. Hallelujah. God, you reign. Hallelujah. There's nobody like you. There's nobody like you. We worship you in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. If my people who were called by my name will humble themselves to pray and seek my face, hallelujah, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins. Hallelujah. 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 You are our strength. Hallelujah. Say you are.
Because of the power of the Lord that he empowers us. And no matter where we are, no matter what we're going through, the Lord's grace is able to reach you. You may be going down deep in despair. You may have lost not only one, but maybe two or three loved ones in this time of this season. But I want you to know that the grace of God that passes all understanding is able to reach you no matter where you are. There's no depth of grief, there's no depth of sorrow that the Lord cannot heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. So we certainly do praise and thank God for the praise team on today. In my heart, I wish you all were here. Amen. There was a release of the anointing in this place. I hope that there was a release of the anointing wherever you are. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, because God is great and he's certainly worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, he's worthy to be praised. And we have a half hour left in our broadcast. Thank you, Lord. So I want to delve deeply into the word of the Lord. And we certainly do thank God and praise God for this opportunity. Hallelujah. Because we need help. Amen. We need God's strength. We need God's presence. Amen. And in his presence is joy, and in his fullness forevermore. And we certainly praise and thank the Lord for each and every one of you that are tuned in on today. And I want just to invite your attention to the book of Acts, Acts chapter number 3. And those that have been following the podcast can see that the Lord is dealing with Pastor Quinn in the book of Acts, amen, and that's the beginning of his church. And the Lord has great and precious promises that he has given unto us. And the church is the greatest government that is upon this earth. The church is the greatest entity or the greatest organism that we ought to seek to be a part of. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, chapter number 6, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto you. And that's our first priority. The priority is the priority, and the priority is to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added. Jesus' first and only sermon was, repent ye, that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And we certainly do thank God for this opportunity to stand here before you, because a few weeks ago, we celebrated Easter. We celebrated the resurrection of Jesus. And right now would be going on. Jesus would be appearing, my Lord, for 40 days. He would be appearing and showing himself alive. I hope that he's appearing and showing up in your life, showing himself alive and doing miracles and wonders, so that people might believe that he is Christ. And in that believing, they might have eternal life. And I can say this, I'm getting ready to go into the message, but I feel a prophetic message coming on in my spirit that preachers, if you listen to the preachers on today and the teachers on today, they're telling you, get ready, get ready, get ready, for the Lord is at hand. The Lord is nigh. No, we don't know the day or the hour when he's coming, but the urgency is we don't want to have him catch us with our works undone. We want to certainly lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset us, so that we can look unto Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. So the Bible tells us to save yourself and them that hear you. It's time out for foolishness. It's time out for playing games. Unreal. Hallelujah. And we ought to get real ourselves. Thank you, Lord. So look to the hills from whence cometh your help. And know that all of your help cometh from the Lord. And I want to go with you, want you to turn with me to a very familiar passage of scripture in the book of Acts, Acts chapter number 3. And I want to begin reading. I want to, my foundational scripture is verse 16. Acts chapter number 3 and verse 16. And I want you, as you're flipping over to there, I want to just give a public announcement that our services are broadcast here on Facebook Live on our Christian Ministries Facebook page, but also our media team in the person of Sister Clarissa Hicks. She's also placing these sermons on our YouTube page. So visit there as well so that you can continue to hear the word of the Lord. I want to give a shout out to all those that are laboring and working with Pastor Quinn to make this a great time and a great production. Amen. And I do certainly do want to thank God for our praise and our worship team. They sacrifice and come out and sing the songs of Zion, and my soul gets filled up with joy. And I do thank God for them and their sacrifice. Amen. Their sacrifice of love. Give our praise team a hand. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. In Acts chapter 16, I just love church. I love everything about the Lord. Hallelujah. It just excites my soul. Thank you, Lord. So let us turn to the book of Acts, Acts chapter number 3 and verse 16. And it says, and his name, through faith in his name, have made this man strong, whom ye see and know. Yea, the faith which is by him have given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. Thank you, Lord. And I just want to read that one more time. And his name, through faith in his name, hath made this man strong, whom ye see and know. Yea, the faith which is by him hath given him this perfect soundness in the presence of ye all. The faith which is by him hath given him this perfect soundness in the presence of ye all. And in his name, through faith in his name, hath made this man strong, whom you know, whom you see and know. O gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, that you grant the door of utterance, grant ears to hear. In Jesus' name, amen. As I said earlier, this is a very familiar passage of Scripture. And it's dealing with the man that Peter and John, the Bible says, went up to the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. They went up to the hour of prayer at 3 p.m. Normally, that would be a time of when they would offer the sacrifice unto the Lord. And as you remember, that's the time that Jesus gave up the ghost and he died. And at 3 p.m., at the giving of the sacrifice. So there was no longer need, my Lord, I feel the Holy Ghost. There was no longer need for a sacrifice, but there was still need for prayer. And this tells us that we should have a time in our lives for prayer. Set a time in your life for prayer, consecration unto the Lord. And Peter and John, they were best buds, so to speak. They were the ones that hung together, that Jesus took aside and taught them privately. Not only them, but a few others. But these two we see predominantly in the scriptures together. So they hung out. They were the first two that ran to the tomb early that Sunday morning to see where if Jesus was still there. So we see that they were still hanging out. They were still together. And they went up at the hour of prayer to pray. And the scripture says, now, when they went up, a certain lame man from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask of alms. And this particular beggar, he was unable to walk, the scripture says, from birth. And the scripture says that he himself was above 40 years old, to whom a miracle had taken place. And they took him daily to the temple. So at this gate called Beautiful, they took him daily there. So it was a routine to take him there. And from a perspective of the scriptures, it's important to note that the reason why this man was taken daily there to ask of alms, he was asking for some money so that he could live because he was unable to provide for himself, that he was taken in the midst of the people on a daily basis. So all would know and see and understand that this was the person whom the Lord had healed. So in the scriptures, it says that this particular person, he was carried there daily, lame at the gate, to ask for alms. Notice verse number 3 says, who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked them for some alms or for some money, for a love offering. And who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, ask of alms, and Peter, fastening his eyes upon him, said, look on us. And the man had gave heed to look upon them. And I love that particular scripture where it says he gave heed and looked upon them because he had an expectation. The scripture says he was expecting to receive something. It's important when you go to the house of the Lord or you're dealing with the man or the woman of God that you yourself have an expectation to receive something. And the Lord can meet your expectation. Not only can he meet your expectation, but he can do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask or think. But you have to expect something. And this lame man that was at the gate, he was expecting something. And then Peter told him that, look on us. He said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee. In the name of Jesus Christ, he said, rise up and walk. And I love that scripture because Peter said, I don't have silver and I don't have gold, but such as I have, give I unto thee. And our subject today is have faith in the name of Jesus for a complete restoration. Have faith in the name of Jesus for a complete restoration. And Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee. Then he said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And then the Bible says that Peter grabbed him by the right hand, and immediately his ankle bone received strength. And the man begins to do something that he's never done before. He began leaping and walking and praising God. And our subject today deals with faith in the name of Jesus. Peter said, silver and gold have I none. The man no doubt could have used some coin, could have used some money. But Peter said, I don't have that, but such as I have. And that what Peter had was faith in Jesus Christ. He shared his faith with the man and tapped into the faith and the power that was in Jesus and grabbed the man by the hand, and he began to stand. He began to leap and walk and praise God. And what I like about this particular chapter or this particular verse is the fact that the man, the Bible doesn't mention anything about his faith. It talks about the faith that Peter had in Jesus Christ that gave perfect soundness to the man wherein he was able to receive healing and deliverance and be made whole. And it was this faith that Peter had in Christ that empowered him to reach out his hand to grab the man, because he had faith that Jesus is able to heal. He had faith that Jesus was able to deliver. He had faith that Jesus and the power that is in Jesus was able to make this man strong. So he acted on his faith. And because he acted upon his faith, he grabbed the man by the hand who was lame from his mother's womb above 40 years and grabbed him by the hand and lifted him up. Hallelujah. And the man begins to walk and to leap and to praise God. The Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And by faith, the Bible says by faith, if you seek God diligently, you will receive a great reward. And faith, when we have faith in God, trust in God, we can do great and mighty things. The scripture says that the righteousness of faith is revealed from faith to faith. And the scripture says that the just shall live by faith. In other words, Peter, he became a conduit, if you will have me to say it, between the lame man and between Jesus. And Peter was able to tap in to the faith that is in Jesus Christ, the power and authority that was in Jesus Christ to help the other man. In other words, my Lord, we ought to be witnesses of the faith that is in Jesus. This, when the scripture says we walk by faith and not by sight, we ought to be witnesses that there's power in the name of Jesus. We ought to live such a lifestyle that people be able to see our faith, to know that we have been with Jesus, to know that we have power, not of ourselves, but our power originates from Jesus. We are recipients of that power. The Bible says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. You've got to have a relationship with the Lord to be strong in the Lord. And what I love about that particular verse is that the Lord has made us. He has made us to be recipients of his power. He has made us to be recipients of his grace. He has made us to be recipients of his strength. The Bible says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But the Lord has made us a savior who was born of a woman under the law. Hallelujah. And he gave his life as a ransom for you and I. And the scripture says, as many as received him, and he has made us to be able to receive him. To as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. And by faith, Peter was and John was walking in that power. By faith, my friend, we ought to walk in the power that has been given unto us. We have to walk in the faith and the power that has been given unto us by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. In other words, Jesus had given them power so that they can be witnesses unto them. And when we look deeper into the scriptures, my Lord, when we look deeper into this word, we can see wherein this lame man that could not walk, he was lame from his mother's womb for 40 years. When Peter and John came to them, Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee. We ought to share our faith with other people. We ought to share the power that the Lord has given us to other people. There are people out there that are dying. There are people out there that need to know Jesus. The people necessarily don't need faith in this respect to receive of God what they need from God. But if you be the witness, if you be the conduit between them and God, they can receive their healing. They can receive their anointing. They can receive their deliverance. They can receive their strength and do things that they've never done before. Hallelujah. If we be the witnesses whom God has called us to be, if we stand in the gap, if we go to prayer, if we pray and fast, if we seek God for the deliverance of other people, Jesus Christ will show up. He will show up with power. He would show up with authority. And what I love about what was taking place here in the scriptures is that the people had known that this was the man that was lame from his mother's womb. The people knew that his condition was a hopeless condition in their own mind. But as we say, he went to a meeting one night and his heart wasn't right. But Jesus, he showed up in his situation. Jesus, he showed up in his condition. And I love it because they knew that a notable miracle had been done in the name of Jesus. And that gave Peter an opportunity to witness about the power that is in Christ. When you are bold and stand in the gap for others and do the miraculous, that gives you an opportunity to stand in the gap and be bold and tell about your Savior. Tell about your deliverer. Tell about the power that is in Christ. And what I love about what was going on was that the people saw the man leaping and worshiping God. They were filled with amazement. They were filled with wonder, my God, and they were wondering about what had happened. But also what was going on behind the scenes as Peter begins to preach to them and tell them what had happened. There was also some naysayers there in the form of the Sadducees and the people that were in charge of the council. Hallelujah, in charge of the temple. That lets me know that people aren't always going to be glad for your deliverance. People are not always going to be happy that the Lord has delivered you and brought you out a mighty long way. That reminds me of the scripture of the woman that walked around. She was a sorceress and said to Peter, not to Peter, but to Paul, these be the men of the Most High God. She was a fortune teller, my Lord, and she told fortunes and made money for her owners. And when Paul looked and saw that she had a spirit upon her, he rebuked the spirit. And you would think that the people would be happy for her, but they weren't happy for her because they had lost their living. They had lost their funds. They had lost their money. They had lost exploiting her. Hallelujah. And they wanted to get rid of those men that performed the great and powerful miracle. My friend, people that have been trying to use you and abuse you, they're not going to be happy when the Lord delivers you. They're not going to be happy and for you when they stop, when you stand strong and resist their attacks. Hallelujah. When you rise up and show yourself strong in the Lord. But I'm stopped by to tell you that be strong in the Lord and in the power of your might. Forget those things that are behind and reach forward to those things that are before you. Don't worry about the people. You've been changed. That's what the scripture means when it talks about you've been transformed by the renewing of your mind to prove what is that good and that perfect will of God. Though God has entered into your life and people gonna see a great change, don't be surprised at those that want to hold you bound, those that want to keep their foot on your neck. Don't be surprised if they're not rejoicing and they're not happy for you. Lift up your head, oh ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory, he shall come in. You rejoice, you give thanks. Hallelujah, because the scripture says that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All old things have passed away. Hallelujah. All things have become new. You tell him for Pastor Quinn, let me see the nails in your hand. You didn't die for me. You didn't deliver me. And this joy that I have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. You ought to give God a praise. You ought to give God a praise. As we move further in our scripture on today, we see that this lame man, he didn't have, the scriptures doesn't bring out the fact that he had faith, but Peter had faith. Huh? He had faith in the power that resides in Jesus Christ. And the scripture says, and this man, through faith in Jesus, have made this man sound, whom you know and whom you see. In other words, a notable change had taken place. Hallelujah. They knew it was the man that was laid at the gate. Ah, but Jesus in power in his name did a complete restoration, did a complete turnaround in his life. If you've got faith to believe in Jesus, he's able to do a complete turnaround in your life. If you have faith to believe in Jesus, he's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask or think. What I like about how it works, the scripture says, faith cometh by hearing, and that by the word of God. And Peter begins to preach. The Bible says there were 5,000 men, hallelujah, men only, that were there at that particular time. They counted them. That's not including the women and the children. They heard Peter preach that by this Jesus, whom the builders set at naught, God had made the head of the corner. And it's not by our own power, it's not by our own might, have caused this perfect soundness to happen, but it was the faith that they had in Jesus, his authority, his power, his glory, he reigns, that gave this man this perfect soundness that you see before us all. My friend, I'm speaking unto you today. If you can tap into the faith that is in Jesus, if you can use your faith, hallelujah, to tap into the power that is in Jesus Christ, to tap into the authority that is in Jesus Christ, you can speak to your mountains and they shall remove. You can speak to your situations and they shall be removed. In other words, if you have faith in Jesus, hallelujah, you can do great exploits in his name. Trouble in your way? You got to cry sometimes? Just have faith in Jesus. My God, a lot of people around this world have lost a lot of loved ones. And I'm sure they're grieving. I'm sure they're sad with sorrow. I'm sure the enemy is fighting their minds. But they've got to rise above the circumstance. Rise above the situation. And just tap into the faith that is in Jesus Christ to receive grace, to receive mercy, to receive strength in your hour of need. The power that is in Jesus, hallelujah, the Bible says it's dunamis power. It's able to give you the strength to get up in the morning, to wash your face, to brush your teeth, to put your clothes on, to walk out your door with a positive attitude. If you put your trust in Jesus, if you put your trust in Jesus, though your finances may be short, hallelujah, though you may not see a way out, if you put your confidence in Jesus, the Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up as wings of eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Hey, Karabosha. My friend, I'm telling you on today, my God, hallelujah, that Jesus is a healer. Hallelujah, that Jesus is a deliverer. Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ. Hey, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life that I now live in the flesh, I don't live by my faith. I live by the faith in the Son of God. I live by the faith that is in Jesus. What is the faith that is in Jesus? That he's able to do exceedingly. That he is our author and the finisher of our faith. That he is our Alpha and Omega. That he's the beginning and the end. What is this faith? That Jesus Christ, he came to this earth. He died on the cross. He died, but he got up on the third day. And when he got up with power. When he got up with authority. So what are you saying, Pastor Quinn? My God, when I believe in that power that rests in Jesus, Jesus transfers that power unto me. When I tap into that power, hallelujah, by faith, hallelujah, Jesus is able to transfer his power unto me and to give me power and authority to do great things upon this earth. When you tap into the power that is in Jesus, he's able to transfer his anointing. He's able to transfer his glory upon you so that you can do great things upon this earth. So that you're able to resist the devil. So that you're able to strengthen yourself in the time of need. You're able to receive of his faith, of his power, and of his glory. You ought to clap your hands and give God some praise because there's power in the name of Jesus. When you walk by this faith, you're able to share your faith. Hallelujah. God, he don't want to just give you faith so that you can hold on into it yourself. Hallelujah. The Bible says, and it talks about faith without works is dead. My Lord, if you have tapped into Jesus, you ought to walk by faith and not by sight. In other words, you ought to share your faith. You ought to tell them that I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. People need to know that there is a Savior. People need to know that there is a deliverer. A lot of people are talking about the coronavirus and getting anxious and getting nervous and losing hope. Oh my God, but we need to tell them about Jesus. Hey, every time they reach in the corona, we ought to tell them about the Christ. Hey, every time they mention the corona, we need to tell them about the Christ. Hallelujah. Who died for us, who got up from the grave, who's able to give you life and that more abundantly. You ought to talk about the one who saved your soul, the lily of the valley and the bright and morning star. You ought to give your God a praise. Hallelujah. If you have faith in him, hey, glory, he's able to give you complete restoration. Hey, he's able to restore your soul. Hey, my God, a lot of us have done some things that were wrong in our lives. A lot of us have all fallen short, of the glory of God. My Lord, you may have fallen short the other day. Hey, glory, hallelujah. You may have fallen short this morning. But the Bible says, come boldly to the throne of grace that you might obtain mercy and find help in the time of trouble, help in the time of need. And that help you can find in Jesus. And by faith, you can tap in to the power that is in Jesus. And I want to say this, that you don't have to be saved to tap into faith that is in Jesus. Hallelujah. Because you got to tap into his faith to get saved. Hallelujah. I remember there was a centurion whose daughter was sick. She lay dying. And he asked, did Jesus speak a word to heal her? And Jesus said, well, I'll go to your house and heal her. And he said, Lord, I'm not worthy that you go to my house. But if you just speak a word, I'm a man under authority. Hallelujah. And I rule people that are under my authority. And I know the power that is in the word. But if you just speak the word, my daughter shall be healed. And Jesus marveled. He said, never have I seen. Notice, he said, never have I seen such great faith. So Jesus tells me that he's looking for people that have great faith. He's looking for people that will trust and believe in him. He's looking for people that will want to do great things in his name. Hallelujah. And he said, if you just speak the word, and my daughter shall be whole. If we just speak the word, Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have. I have the master. I have the savior. I have the power that is in Jesus Christ. And I'm going to exercise my faith and cause this individual to be made whole. Hallelujah. If that's what the Lord wants us to do, he wants us to believe on him. Believe in God. Hallelujah. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. As it is written, the just shall live by faith. We have to live by faith. What type of faith? Faith that is in Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Hallelujah. He dictates our faith. He's the beginning of our faith and the finisher or the refiner of our faith. Hallelujah. In other words, Jesus, when you believe in him, I feel like teaching. I feel like talking about him. But when you believe in him, he's able to add to your faith virtue, to knowledge, temperance, patience, brotherly kindness. And he said, if these things be in you and above, ye should never be barren nor unfruitful. Hallelujah. And Jesus is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among them that are sanctified because he is the word. And the Bible says faith cometh by hearing and not by the word of God. Completeness and soundness of spirit, soul, and body comes through Jesus Christ. You can't be complete without him. You can't be strong without him. Yeah, you can attempt to be strong in your own might, but you'll lose. But if you be strong in the Lord, thanks be to God that giveth us the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You'll always win. Hallelujah. You'll be a winner if you put your faith in Jesus. You'll be a winner if you put your confidence in him. And my last point, I want to say, believe that God is and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Believe that God is, that God exists. Hey, hallelujah. And that when you seek him, he will bless you. If you seek him, he will help you. I was telling one of the mothers of the church on this week, last week, so to speak, that I didn't realize it. The Lord was dealing with me. That from a young child, I was seeking the Lord. Didn't know it. Wanted help. Didn't know it. calling out to God. Didn't know it. Hallelujah. That was a process of seeking him. My friend, if you look back over your life, hallelujah, there's some times in your life where you called on the name of the Lord and you may have felt that he hasn't heard you, but now is the time. Now is the time. Now is the day of salvation. He said, when you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Turn to the Lord and he will help you. Turn to the Lord and he will deliver you. Hallelujah. The Lord is nigh thee, even in thy mouth. Hallelujah. And he wants to show himself strong. He's looking to show himself strong in thee. The deeper you are, the greater the deliverance. The more struggle that you're in, the greater the power. Hallelujah. That he will expose unto you to deliver you out of your situation. Hey, glory. And then believe that Jesus is the Christ and that through him you can obtain salvation. Believe that Jesus is the healer. Believe that Jesus is the deliverer. Whatever you need as far as your life to be restored, it's all in Jesus. A complete restoration in your life can happen through him. And you know, there's a lot of things that we've done wrong in our lives. There's a lot of things I don't tell people that I have done because I'm ashamed of it. But the Lord knows, hallelujah, he knows all of my shame. He knows all of my guilt. He knows all of my struggle. Hallelujah. And if I was here amongst my congregation, I'd make them tell the same thing so I wouldn't be alone. Hey, hallelujah, because you've done some things in your own life that you're ashamed of. You've done some things that you feel guilty about that you don't tell nobody about. But Jesus knows. Hallelujah. He knows all about your struggles. Hallelujah. And he himself, when he shows up in your life, he shows up with complete restoration. He shows up with complete deliverance. Why? Because he himself was touched with the feelings of your infirmities. And it was because of your infirmities was he made manifest on this earth to take whatever was wrong with you to the cross, to die on the cross for you and to express his victory that he gained for you so that you can have life and that more abundantly. So when the enemy brings up your past, you can tell them there's no condemnation. Hey, to them that are in Christ Jesus. When he brings up your past, you can tell them that I was crucified. I was buried with Christ in baptism. And I'm raised now to walk in the newness of life. You don't know me after the flesh, but I walk in the spirit now. Oh, I got power. I got authority. And every time that he brings that up, because of the power and authority that is in Jesus, you're able to overcome those negative thoughts. You're able to overcome those negative actions that you did in the past. Why? Because he lives. And because he lives, you can live also. So I want you to pray with me. Normally, this time I'd make the altar call, make the water call. Amen. Thank you, Lord. But I need you to pray with me. And you know what? I used to be a hard component of the sinner's prayer. Thank you, Jesus. But the Lord has showed me something in this respect, that you do got to confess and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. And because I'm not there with you, thank you, Lord, I need you to confess that Jesus is the Christ. Ha! That Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. And if you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth, the scripture says, ye shall be saved. And because of your confession of faith and your belief in Christ, then you can get baptized in the name of Jesus and be filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. You still need the baptism. You still need the Holy Ghost. Let's be clear. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So let us confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hey, Karabosha. Let us confess that Jesus Christ is the Savior. Hallelujah. And if you want to be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sins, You can call me. Hallelujah. Inbox me. And I'll make a way. Hallelujah. I'll baptize. You can get baptized in your own tub. Hallelujah. I'll just say the prayer over you and baptize you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You can get baptized here at Christian Ministries. I'll baptize you in the name of Jesus. I'll put on a mask. I'll put you on a mask and we'll put you down in Jesus' name. Hey, hallelujah. And if you repent, God will fill you with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Complete restoration, complete power, complete deliverance. That's the prescription on today. Let us pray. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We believe in your name. We believe in the power that's in your name. We ask you, Lord, that you sanctify our hearts, our minds, and our spirit. Lord, you send forth your deliverance. You send forth your strength. And Lord, by faith, we tap into your power. By faith, we tap into your anointing. By faith, we tap into your glory, your authority, in the name of Jesus, that we may manifest it in our lives on a daily basis, that we may lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Give us that strength that we should tread upon serpents and scorpions, and give us that power over all the enemy in the name of Jesus. Lord, we tap into that power and that strength that we might love our friends, that we may love our husbands and our wives, that we may love our enemies, that we may show forth the grace and the power that is in Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Give God a praise. Lord, we thank you for this word on today. What I want you to get out of this is that there's restoration in Jesus. That there's deliverance in Jesus. If you need to be restored, by faith, touch into the restoring power. If you need grace and strength, tap into that restoring grace and power. Hallelujah. For this cause was he made manifest upon this earth. Hallelujah. The grace of God has appeared unto all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldliness, we should live soberly and righteously down here in this present world. By faith, you can tap into the faith that is in Christ and receive the infilling. Receive the infusion of his power. Receive the infusion of his authority so that you can manifest dominion and kingdom power here upon this earth. And God, I'm dying to be done, but God has given us power and strength to do great exploits here upon this earth. They sung earlier. They're talking about his availing love. It avails. Thank you, Jesus. And that word avails means it shows up. When you're weak, his availing love will show up. When you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, his availing love, it'll show up because it reaches. Hallelujah. It reaches through the dunghill. It reaches through your oppression and depression. It reaches through whatever you're going through to bring you out, not just a conqueror, but bring you out more than a conqueror. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah. No man can take you out of his hand. Hey, I'm trying to shut this off. Thank you, Lord. But no man is able to take you out of his hand. You've got to touch in, tap in by faith to that power that is in Jesus Christ. And as I said earlier, in my conclusion again, thank you, Lord, that tapping in, everybody was given a measure of faith. Amen. You have a measure of faith, whether you are a sinner or whether you are a saint. God has given you a measure of faith, and you should use your measure of faith to tap into the faith that is in Jesus Christ. And if you can tap into the faith that is in Jesus, you can be restored. You can be saved. I want to say this again. My God. God is bringing back everything he put in my mind concerning this sermon that he wants me to share with you. So just bear with me just for one more second. That I remember that I used to be a former member of Antioch Baptist Church. And as a young lad growing up, I didn't pay too much attention to the Word of God. And shame on me, because I should have. Thank you, Jesus. But what they taught me was that when you pray, pray in the name of Jesus. When you pray, pray in the name of Jesus. I didn't know that there was power and authority in that name. I didn't know about what the depths of power, the depths of authority that I know now that is in that name. But when I got in trouble, hey, hallelujah, I didn't have to know all of that. All I needed to know was the name, calling on the name. And when I called on the name, hey, hallelujah, the Lord saved my soul. When I called on the name, hallelujah, I said, Lord, help me in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Lord, he delivered my soul. He brought me out of a world of sin and shame. Why? Because I called on the name. Anybody that calls on the name, it's legitimate power. It's legitimate authority. There's no other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved. It's the only name that God has provided for salvation. Hey, hallelujah. So I ain't got to search around. I could just call on the name. Hey, one-stop shopping. My God, hallelujah. And God will deliver your soul. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Hallelujah. Pray for Pastor Quinn. Hallelujah, because the zeal of the Lord has eaten me up. Hey, hallelujah. And I'll pray for you in Jesus' name. Amen.